8:45.
Is it?
No way.
We're just checking to see if you do that. Yes, it is.
Before 10 o'clock. How about that?
You got to make sure you...
Oh, you want to do it on last? Okay.
I did them in the order you gave me.
All right, this is...
Up here. Of course, there you go.
This is excess inventory. These are 3/8 and 1/2 end mills. As you can see, we have a lot of them. Honestly, we could probably get away with 4 of each, and we wouldn't really have a problem as long as we weren't ruining them.
Right.
So, but let me, we have drawers of things like that.
So the question is how long does it take to get one anyhow?
I can't pay any more than a day.
Right. So, okay.
A lot of this came because we got stuff from Bosch. Right. I guess we accumulated. This is overpusseled. It's also, I guess you could consider it a defect. When this tool was put together last, that bolt was left loose. It backed itself out, hit the shoe, and the ejection system wouldn't return. So now the overprocessing is, instead of them hanging the tool and running it, they gotta hang it, pull it, you gotta take it back apart, fix it again, put it back together and hang it again. I mean, that's gotta be at least 2 hours of wasted time. This is overprocessing because these are inserts that are big, so we keep them over here on a separate rack. With the wasted motion, we don't necessarily know where the inserts are, so they can be either in these cabinets, so we come over here and look at it, then we come over to them, realize not here, go over there and look, assuming that they're in either location, and there isn't any, it doesn't tell us where they go back to or anything like that.
Okay.
These are mold straps. There's been a mold strap made for probably 75% of the tools in this building, and there's probably mold straps on about 5% of them. So obviously on some tools the mold strap isn't necessary, but it would be good for us to build something that's maybe a little universal. But sometimes the mold strap just needs to be used one time to put the tool on. These are the cabinets that we moved up front. One of the big issues is not only do we need certain bolts, we have to go all the way up front, but we don't even necessarily know if we have them. So we're going all the way up front to find out. There's a good chance we'll find out that there's a cup bag that we don't have. There's actually a cup. This is the same kind of bag. That's all the way up front, too. And that's ejector pins, cabinet full spring, things like that. Things that we use probably. I know I walked up there all the time. This is a really good colorful one that you can visually see for waste potential, but this, as you can see, we have quite a few tools missing from in here. Somebody even took a ratchet right off of the socket. Not just a socket, at least. So as long as you got a good grip, you can just break them loose at the end. My point here, though, is that a lot of time and effort was put in, not just with people in the tool room, but with people from other departments that got involved in building this ambulance, also with all the toolboxes on the floor that people put a lot of time and effort in. When those people look at this and they see it looking like crap, it really, it's a curse of wanting to do it again. It really kind of creates cynicism and things like that. Obviously isn't doing anything good for us. And then this one, I don't know if this is our area or not, but as you can see, there's just about every possible waste here. You can't find anything. It looks bad. We can't even get the skids lined up. So, yeah, there's just about every kind of way. Almost every call them out of the eight are there.
Okay. Very good.
Thank you, guys.
All right. Thank you very much. All right, so one of the things Ashley meant about, getting frustrated because it's not there. The reason why it's probably not there is because they don't have it somewhere else. They know it's there, right? So they go and grab it. So once we get it to the locations it needs to be, that stuff should reside. So it should go away from stealing from different places. Because where do we go to find something when we need it? The place we know where it's at, right? So we take it from there. So we just got to make sure we got the right places. please check the Kaizen events. Those are the, we don't have any customer visits, so we want to make sure we're checking the Kaizen events. Also for the improvement, this came up a while back. I think Laura and I took a video, and I couldn't find a video about it. We used to lay that hose across the whole dock, so they have to get off the forklift, pick up the hose, and hang it back up, so they wouldn't run it over because people are using it to build a truck or their vans, tires, and so forth. So Marty and Trent then got the hose over, hooked it up right to the handle, so it's right there. So now it's not laying across. So now we don't have to worry about driving over it. Laura doesn't have to stop, pick it up, and get back on the forklift and go, or whoever's loading the truck. So let's get Marty and Trent a hand. Thank you. Thanks for coming. Thank you. And there's an air gauge on that, so you don't have to take it off and put it back on to figure out if you got the right PSI, okay? So that's very good. Thank you. We're going to go back to clear a quick sec. The reader here about the 2 seconds here. Alright. The morning meeting allowed us to implement the first stage of building the lean culture, which is teaching and training people, but we still need to impart an expectation of continuous improvement. We needed people to make improvements on a daily basis so that we could produce a higher quality product at a lower cost, while also enjoying regular sense of accomplishment in our work environment. Lean is not just about growing people so they feel all happy and involved. It is also about results, measurable, concrete results that show a continual pattern of improvement. How do we do that? If I tell my people, hey, I want to make one improvement a day, they would look at me kind of cross-eyed. Most would respond, I don't know if I can think of one improvement today, every day. It sounds like a tall order, doesn't it? So I changed it again to something simple. Remember, the Hoax model. The beauty of their company was that they kept the process very simple in order to ensure the maximum buy-in from their people. I said to my people, just give me a 2-second improvement a day. That's it. That's all I ask for, a 2-second improvement. There's not a person on earth, let alone a mouse or a hamster, that can't figure out how to improve something by just 2 seconds. I made the bar so low that everyone could jump it. And indeed, that's what happened. Alright, so remember, it doesn't have to be a big, we're not looking for a home run, we're just looking for small improvements every day, okay? This is a video about, we will see.